This is a hammer that I've designed and built myself. You can see that the cylinder is mounted inside the frame of the hammer. Makes for a low profile compact hammer. The frame of the hammer itself is made from half inch thick plate that I burned out on my CNC plasma table. The anvil is a laminated anvil from 1x10 bar stock that has a 2-inch thick separate plate on the top made from 1045. Here's a shot of the cylinder connecting to the ram or the head. The unique thing about this hammer is I've utilized steam hammer technology, being in that I have a control valve and steam hammer style linkage. There are no limit switches or solenoids or anything on this hammer, and it makes for a really, really controllable and just a wonderful hammer to use.
This is a piece of 1-inch round stock, 8 inches long. I'm just upsetting it just to show how easy it is to go from an 8-inch height down to a 1-inch height with no adjustments or changes to the power hammer itself. Here I am hot punching a half inch round hole into a piece of 1/2x3 bar stock. You can see how easy it is to go from the tool height, which is about 6 inches, down to the half inch thick material with no adjusting to the power hammer whatsoever. Here I go from multiple blows to single hit blows, again without any adjustments to the power hammer. This is a piece of 1/2-inch square stock that I'm going to taper about 5 inches. I'll then split it down the middle about 4 inches using a hot set. And this can all be done in one heat.